Hey guys, Brett here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up and use the List Magnet WordPress plugin. Now what this plugin does is it creates a popover on your WordPress site that will allow people to opt in via email, via Facebook. It will display a video if you like, and it will have a countdown timer till it auto closes, and it can even be set to lock content, which forces people to opt in order to continue if you choose. So let me show you how to set up the plugin itself. I have it on my WordPress blog right now. I'm going to go ahead to the List Magnet page and click on the Create New button. Now in the plugin, the pop-ups are referred to as locks. And this is because, as I said, you can use them to lock your content if you want. The very first thing you're going to be asked for is a lock name. Now this name is only for your reference, so that way you can know what the pop-up is for. So I'm going to go ahead and just enter a test here. The second thing it's going to ask you for is your lock text. Now this is the text that appears at the top of your pop-up. You can use the Add Media button to enter graphics, and from that point it's just the normal WordPress WYSIWYG editor. You generally want to add some text that's going to tell people why they should sign in. If you're locking the content, you would want to tell them sign in to continue or opt in to continue. If you're just trying to capture some emails, you might want to just tell them the benefits of why they should sign up. To make it easy for myself, I'm actually just going to use a graphic that I have here. So I'll click the Add Media button and enter my graphic. So now that I have my content and my text set up, I'm going to be asked what kind of lock do I want. Now there are a couple of different choices. The very first one is an email only lock. Now with this type of lock, people are given the option to opt in by manually typing in their email address and clicking the sign in button. The second type is email or Facebook. With this option, they can manually type in their email address, or they can alternatively click the Login with Facebook button, which will get their name and email address via Facebook sign up with a single click. The final option is to have no opt-in form at all. And the reason you might want to have this type of lock is if you just want to display an ad, or you want to display some type of notification or notice, or maybe a different product for sale over your content. You could use the no opt-in option. There's going to be some basic settings such as YouTube video code. So if you want to have a YouTube video underneath your text, you can enter the video code and it will pull in a YouTube video that will play. You can enter settings like your lock border color, which is just the color border around the pop-up. You can select the background color, which is the background color of the pop-up. You can decide if you want to show a close button. So if you want to force people to opt in or force people to watch the ad, you generally would not have a close button. But if you want to do a little more of a soft sell on them, you might want to have a close button so they could just get rid of it if they choose to and get right to the content. You're going to be asked if you want to have a delay time. Now the delay time is the number of seconds that the pop-up will wait before it finally shows. You're going to be asked for a countdown time. The countdown time is the number of seconds before it auto-closes. So if I enter 60 here, the pop-up will count down 60 seconds and then automatically close whether or not the person has opted in. And this is useful for if you want to be a little bit more of a soft sell on it. It's also useful if you have a pop-up that is locking content. Maybe you're going to show an ad, but you don't want to force them to click on the ad. You want them to be able to get to your content, so you make them watch the ad for 60 seconds and then it'll close on its own. If you have an opt-in email form, you can enter the custom form sign-up text right here. Finally, we have our autoresponder integration. The List Magnet WordPress plugin integrates automatically with AWeber, MailChimp, or GetResponse. If you use either of these autoresponders, you can enter your autoresponder settings in here, and any signups via email or via the Facebook Connect will automatically go to your autoresponder. If you don't use one of these autoresponders, you can always download a CSV of all of the emails you collected. So now that we have our pop-up created, we can go back to the home page, and you're going to see it creates a custom shortcode for each pop-up that you create. So all you have to do then is copy and paste this shortcode, go over to your posts or go over to your pages, and paste that shortcode into any post or page that you want the pop-up to show on. Now you can create as many pop-ups as you want, and you can put them individually on any posts that you want. This way you don't have to limit yourself to one particular pop-up, one particular settings. So I can have an email opt-in form on one page, and on another page I can lock the content and force people to sign up with Facebook, and on another page I can have a video which is an ad and a JVZoo button underneath it. And because of this, and because it uses custom shortcodes to create multiple pop-ups, you don't have to limit yourself to one particular pop-up across your entire site. You can customize it for each post or page to suit your needs. At any time you like, you can always go back and view or edit your pop-up and change it. You can delete it if you like, and you can also view the pop-in stats. So I'll show you the stats quick. We'll click the stats button, and it's going to show you the total number of times that the pop-up was displayed. That is the total pop-up hits, which in this case you can see on my personal blog and my personal tests was 685. It's going to show you the number of unique hits. Now it tracks unique hits by IP address, and it is also important to note that if someone signs up, it will save their IP address that they have signed up, so that way we don't keep spamming them the pop-up over and over again when they've already signed up. So the unique hits for this example was 417, and it will show you the total number of signups, 198, and finally it will calculate your opt-in rate, which in this case was 47.4%. Now these stats are in real time, up to the minute stats. And anytime you want, you can go ahead and click the download signups button, which will download a CSV file with all of your signups email addresses in it. So that's a real quick look at the List Magnet WordPress pop-up script. Thank you and enjoy.